welcome to my channel. My name is Liz and this is Simply Homeschool. So today I am going to walk you guys through all of my history picks for our supplements. I hope that this is helpful and I hope that you guys enjoy. So let's get started. Basically what we have for our supplements for history this year, and some of it will be used in geography as well, but for the most part we're using it for history. So I'm just going to kind of walk through each item with you and tell you what it is. So the first thing I have here is this American Revolution Colonial Teapot. It comes with this little guide and how to paint it. So here is the little teapot. It's actually a piggy bank. We're not really going to drink out of it, which would have been really awesome. But we have that. It came with this little paint kit and the paintbrush with the little sponge. So we will be using this when we learn about the Boston Tea Party. So this comes with a paper that you unroll, the feather pen, and the quill, I should say, and a little bottle with ink powder in there, and they get to write their own, I don't know, maybe constitution, or I'm not sure what we're gonna do with these yet, but I thought that these were really cool. These were from Rainbow Resources. We also have the constitution, and it came with this cool little pen as well. So we thought that this would be pretty fun to just look over and try to read, even though you can't really see the words, but we just thought it'd be fun for them to hold it and look at it and see the signatures on them. So we have that. We also picked up some of these All American Girls collection books. This is Welcome to Samantha's World, and this is Growing Up in 1904. So it literally just walks through that time. So I thought that this would be cool to look through when we are working through 1904. All right, so the next thing here is this Scholastic Race Across the USA game. I purchased this from Amazon. I don't think I mentioned that I purchased the All-American Girl dolls from Amazon as well, and then the teapot I purchased from Rainbow Resources. But this was purchased from Amazon. It's just a game to learn about the states, the state capitals, state locations, and state facts. So it has history facts in here, or historical facts. I thought that this would be fun. This is for ages 8 and up, and it's 2 to 4 players. Next, we have Kirsten's World. This is taking place back in 1854, so that would be a fun thing to read through. Welcome to Addie's World. This is 1864. We have Who Was Sacagawea? We thought that this would be a good read while we're reading through the beginning in our history book about Native Americans. I saw this and had to have it. This is The Little Leaders, Bold Women in Black History. It has some really great women in here. So this is a sprinter. This is a poet, an actress, singer, a tennis champion, NASA mathematician. So I thought that this would be really nice to read as well, to go through on the times, because not only does it say what they did, it says what year they did it in. So I thought that this would be a fun history thing to read through as well. We have Rosa Parks. This is by Kane Miller, and it's The Extraordinary Life of Rosa Parks. We also have Wonders of the USA. This is a Shine a Light book. This is from Usborne. So this book is really cool. You literally use a flashlight behind the book as you read. So I usually do it at night in the room with the kids before bed. And I just have them hold the flashlight and they hold it up behind the chalkboard and it would show something through the chalkboard. Same thing to all of these. You'd hold the flashlight up behind here and it would shine through something that you're reading about. So it is really awesome, it's really hands-on, and the kids absolutely love it. Also picked up Josephina's World, and this is from 1824. This is Growing Up on America's Southwest Frontier. And the last book we have here is Molly's World in 1944, and this is Growing Up in World War II, America. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. I hope that you guys found some helpful items on here that you see would fit in perfectly with your guys' curriculum. Now, this is not everything. I'm not showing anything that we use in our curriculum for Star Spangled Story. We do a lot of hands-on activities through that curriculum, and I will be posting a lot of things on my Instagram from our day-to-day life on what activities we're doing or experiments and things like that. So make sure you go ahead and go check that out. I hope again that you guys enjoyed this. Please do not forget to hit that subscribe, the like, and the notification bell. It helps so much when you guys like a video and you just hit that like button. And I hope that this video finds you guys happy and healthy, and be blessed always.